Hello students, this is Monica, PGT in Computer Science from Sri G. K. Jain High Secondary School. Today I am going to teach for 11th Standard Chapter 3 Computer Organization. And this chapter is common for both the stream Computer Science and Computer Applications. Before going to the chapter, first students you have to know why we are learning this chapter by knowing the learning objectives of it. For example, before going any chapter, it can be a HTML, it can be a C++ or any theory based topic. First, you have to know why we are learning this chapter and how this chapter will be useful for us in a practical oriented way. So, the learning objectives of this chapters are, the first one, you will come to know about the organization of the computer components and the interconnections. Computer components in the sense all your hardware components. So how will you organize all your hardware components and how the hardware components will be interconnected for your process. And the second topic you will come to know about the processors and the characteristics. So what is the built-in processor in your CPU and what are the characteristics of that processor which mainly depends on. And the third topic, you will come to know about the memory devices. What are the memory devices you have and what are the roles and responsibilities of that memory devices. And you will explore about RAM and ROM. And you will come to know about the ports and interfaces. So that how will you connect the external devices to the system. And the last topic you will come to know about the secondary memory devices. And what are the usages of that secondary devices. So these are the learning objectives. And after you learn this chapter, you will all come to know all these points by learning this chapter. Without further delay, I'm just giving you the introduction. What is computer organization is all about. Computer organization is mainly deals with the hardware components of your computer system. Hardware components in the sense, you know what are the hardware components you have. You have input-output devices, you have CPU, you have memory devices. Input-output devices in the sense, you know, keyboard, mouse, monitor, all your components, whatever you are feeling and whatever you are touching, that all comes under your hardware devices. And this organization explains you how these components actually operate. It will tell you how these components are interconnected with each other and how these components will be actually operated. Now coming to the basics of microprocessor. We will start the microprocessor by the word CPU. Since CPU, I told you, already explained you in the previous chapter, CPU is a major component and that performs all your tasks. And the performance of all the tasks is realized by the microprocessor, which is an integrated circuit. And this microprocessor is a programmable multi-purpose silicon chip which can accept the input as the binary data, and after all the processing get over, the output data will be given as per the instructions in your memory unit. And this microprocessor basically deals with the three main units. The first one is ALU, the second one is control unit, and the third one is registers. ALU is nothing but it's an arithmetic and logical unit, and this unit performs all your arithmetic and logical operations. And I explained you what all the arithmetic operators and what are your logical operators in the previous chapter. Arithmetic operators in the sense it will deal with your addition, subtraction, multiplication, division and your modulus. And logical operations in the sense it deals all your logical gates, starting from your AND, OR, NOT and all your derived gates and the universal gates. And coming to the second point is your control unit. Control unit is nothing but it controls the overall operations of your computer through the signal. For example, if you want to transfer a data from the input unit to the processor, or you want to fetch the data from the memory unit for processing, or after the processing if you want to send your output data to the output devices. So all these operations are controlled by your control unit through the signals. And coming to the last unit is your registers. Registers are nothing but it is used to hold instructions or data. So whatever the user is giving as an instruction or as a data, it will store that instructions or data that is used for the execution of your processor. So while the processor needs your data or the instruction to be executed, it takes from the registers. And here is your a flow diagram that explains you about the data flow through the microprocessor. The same diagram explained you in the first chapter with the CPU. So instead of CPU, here we are using the microprocessor, because all the operations of the CPU, whatever CPU is doing, all that operations are realized and doing actually by the microprocessor. So it is taking the input from the input unit as a binary data, and after the processing, all your output will be stored in a memory for the future purpose, and that output will be given also for the output device for the display based on the instructions stored in the memory. So this is the diagram that explains you about the flow of the data or the execution process under the microprocessor. Next, we are moving to the characteristics of microprocessor. Coming to the characteristics of the microprocessor, each and every processor will depends on these characteristics. The first one is your clock speed, and the second one instruction set, and the third characteristic is your word size. Coming to the first one, clock speed. Clock speed is nothing but each microprocessor has an internal clock, and that regulates the speed at which your processor executes the instruction. For example, if a user giving a instruction or data to the processor, that is to the CPU. So while taking that data for the processing and giving the data back as the output, so that overall time will be calculated by the internal clock, which will be in the microprocessor itself, and that regulates the speed of the microprocessor while taking the data to giving the output back. So that particular time will be calculated. You can tell, in other words, the speed at which your microprocessor executes the instruction is nothing but your clock speed. And this clock speed is measured in megahertz or gigahertz. You can write it as mhertz, megahertz, or you can write it as gigahertz. And coming to the next characteristic is your instruction set. Instruction is nothing but a command which is given to the computer to perform any specific operation on a particular data. So that command is said to be a instruction. Whatever command, for example, if I have to add two numbers, I will send a instruction as add 2, 3. This is an instruction given to the computer to add two numbers. So this is what is called as a data given by the user. That is what is called as an instruction. And this instruction set will carry out these operations. It will take responsibility for the data transfer. Data transfer is nothing but the transfer of data internally from your input to the output devices, or from memory to the output, or from memory to the processor, or processor to the memory. So all your data transfers will be taken care by this instruction set, and it carried out your arithmetic operation. I told you already, starting from your addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and your modulus. And the logical operations, I told you, starting from your AND or NOT gate and all your derived gates. So all these operations will be taken care by this instruction set. And input output operations and the control flow. Control flow is nothing but the data that the data will be flow from one part, like you have to get a data from the input device to the processor, or you have to send the data from a processor to the memory for the storing. So all these controlling flow will be taken care by this instruction set. And the last characteristic is your word size. Word size is nothing but the number of bits processed by the processor in a single instruction. For example, an instruction is given by the user to the processor. So if that instruction is 8 bits, so the word size will depend on the number of bits processed by the processor. And this word size will determine the amount of RAM, that is memory, that can be accessed by the microprocessor at one single time, and the total number of pins on the microprocessor. So this word size will determine these both. So these are the characteristics of your microprocessor. Students, today I taught you about the basics organizations in your computer and what are the interconnections and the processor and this characteristics. Hope you understood the topic, whatever I taught today. And this chapter will be continuing in my next video also. Thank you, students.